What's going on, monsters and realtors? It's Mike Maloney, your realtor's favorite realtor. Welcome to the first edition of Cash and Keys. Now, I know a lot of you have been seeing a couple of my posts. Me and my lender, Dimitri, aka Mortgage Master, we are getting our own show and podcast for Clear Vision Network. Now, Cash and Keys is our idea of, you know, little mini segues, little segments off the main show. So we're going to combine everything in together. But when I speak, I'm going to do it on a couple of webcams. If I'm on my cell phone, I'm just going to brand the solo editions of myself as Cash and Keys. I'm the key man. Dimitri's the cash man. So we're still a team and we're going to have some fun with this. So real estate questions, ask me. Lending questions, you ask him. That's how we're going to do it. But happy Monday, everybody. The day's almost over. I just got back from the gym, trying to relax a little bit. I'm home. I'm actually in the office right now. So you can see it's so messy behind me. But hey, this is what it is. I'm a man. What can I tell you? This is the man cave. So welcome. But let's get started. I wanted to start this off with five tips, five, that every home buyer who's searching for their dream home should know. I'm gonna keep it simple and short though, just so I can keep your attention. One, get your pre-approval. This happens more than you can imagine. People shop around, they don't have a pre-approval, fall in love with a house, try to make an offer. I do not accept an offer if it does not have a pre-approval on it, so I can't expect other agents to accept an offer without a pre-approval. So guess what? While you're rushing to get your pre-approval on a hot house, somebody walked in the door with that piece of paper. He got the deal because he planned his attack better than you did. And number two for that little part of that, know what you can buy. Everybody thinks they can buy a $1 million house because they have great income and great credit. The truth is, there's a bunch of algorithms that these banks use, and they're not just going to give away $1 million. Find out the number so you can go searching accordingly, so you don't get your hopes up, and you know exactly the price range that you're looking in and the neighborhoods that you could afford. So now, part tip number two. Know the difference between your must-haves and your would-likes to have. Pretty simple, too. Your must-have 3 bedrooms, you must have 4 bedrooms, you must have 2 bathrooms, you must have a backyard, you must have a basement. Those are must-haves. Would like to have. Pool, finished basement, tennis court, movie room, a bar. Those most likely are would like to haves. Because if a home doesn't have them, you still will buy the house. You're just going to have to put your would like to haves in when you're done. So know the difference between what you need to have and what you would like to have. And your journey will be a lot easier. Number 3, research and choose the neighborhood you want to live in. Don't leave this up to the agent. I'm very good in Queens, Long Island, Brooklyn. I know the boroughs. I know the cities in Long Island. I'm lucky enough to where I grew up in Queens and hung out in Brooklyn, and I'm lucky enough that all my jobs actually happened to have been out in Long Island. So I know all the way to Suffolk County. Still doesn't help me when someone tells me anywhere under 600,000. I'm going to send you a list of 1,000 homes, and you're going to hate me because you think I'm an idiot, and I'm not providing you, which you don't think I'm listening to you, but what you're doing is setting yourself up for disaster. Know the area, know the towns you want to live in, know the school districts you want to aim for, stick with it, and share that with your agent. Do not tell him anywhere in Queens under 600,000. That's going to be a list of 300 homes. I get it every day. Anywhere in Queens, anywhere in Long Island. Do you know Long Island is also considered Nassau and Suffolk, basically, to a lot of people? So do you mean Nassau? Do you mean deep Suffolk? You really have to narrow that down for the agent. It will make your life easier, and it will make their life easier. Hopefully, I'm your agent, so hopefully it's my life. But I'm just saying, know the areas that you want to live in. That is your responsibility. You could ask for suggestions, but the agents we don't know your full history, your full background, where your family lives or anything like that. So you have to be very candid with us and let us know the exact neighborhood that you want to live in. Pretty simple, right? Number four, pick a style of a house that you like and then stay with it. If you like colonials, look for colonials. You like capes, look for capes. You like old Victorians, stick to them. Do not have an open concept unless you're okay with either or, because what's gonna happen is the agent's gonna send you a lot of stuff and you're gonna think in your head, this guy's not listening to me. I don't like this type of house. Well, tell the agent. If you don't like the capes because of the ceilings and the second floor, tell the agent. If you love colonials, the center colonial, tell the agent. We are here to make your lives easier by using our expertise and knowledge in the areas. And we've been around this for a while. We have tough skin. Don't be scared of telling us that we're wrong sometimes, that, oh, you sent me these type of houses. You know what? I'm realizing I don't really like the way they are on the second floor. Okay, tell us. We're here to make your lives, this part of your chapter of your life, you're gonna remember it forever. So I'm here to help you get through this process, love it, and love it to the point when you're done, you're gonna brag to everybody you know about how good I was. Now, me as good as I was also comes a lot from the information you tell us. We are miracle workers, don't get me wrong. We make miracles happen, but you have to speak with us so we can be on the same page and make those miracles happen for you. And number five, last but not least, document your home visits. Sounds simple, sounds stupid, but if you happen to be a pickier buyer and you're looking for something very specific, write down the houses you're going to, take pictures and document them. Have a column in the spreadsheet that says, didn't like this, like that, didn't like the kitchen, bathroom too small. It's not to drive you nuts. It's so that when the agent is giving you other properties that you might be interested in, everybody's on the same page. And you'll know what you've seen. And after about 2-3 months of looking for homes, if you're one of those buyers that checks out 3 homes a week, you know, whatever, all the homes are gonna blend into one. So you're gonna remember certain things about certain houses, but you're not gonna be able to really pinpoint them after looking for 3 months, just because you've seen so much. So it's gonna be hard for you to remember. So don't be shy, bring your camera. If you feel weird about recording in a house, ask the agent. They're gonna let you record. Bullshit us. Tell us it's for your wife. Tell us it's for your husband. He's not there right now. I don't care if you are married or not at that moment. If I don't know you, just have fun. Tell me, oh, my wife couldn't make it today. Can I take a video of the house? Go for it. I'm trying to sell that house. I'm gonna let you do everything that you can legally and everything that I think is respectful enough to get that house sold. And if that includes letting you walk around with your camera on FaceTime, showing your significant other, or even taking pictures of each room, I'm gonna let you do it. So don't be shy and have fun doing this. And there you go. Mikey Monstar, your realtor's favorite realtor, working with Laffy Real Estate. And I love what I do. So please stay tuned. You're gonna see a lot more episodes like this coming out. I'll try to keep them short and sweet so I don't lose your interest. You know, I know people don't, you know, you give a bathroom break for a couple minutes. That's when a lot of us watch videos, right? All right. So how long could you really be in the bathroom for? So I'll keep them short. Just want to say thank you for tuning in. You will see a lot more content coming out from Cash and Keys, Clear Vision Network, me and my lender teaming up, and we'll have special guests on the show as well. So please subscribe, have fun, send me a message, got a question, don't be shy. Visit my website, MichaelMaloneyRealEstate.com. Have a good one, Monstars and Realtors. Have a good night.